Doctor, let's talk about the efficacy and safety of the vaccine. How does the vaccine work? Were there any side effects in the trials, and in what percentage? And others are claiming efficacy rates are higher than 90%. So what exactly do you mean by 90% efficacy?
So our clinical efficacy trial investigates the safety and the efficacy of our vaccine in more than 40,000 subjects. And this is a randomized blinded trial. That means neither the company nor the investigators nor the volunteers do not know if they get placebo or the vaccine. And this allows us to assess the safety of our vaccine. And in the assessments so far with more than 40,000 subjects, we see that the safety profile of the vaccine appears to be very benign. We see only temporary side effects in about 15% of the subjects with temporary mild to moderate fever for one or maximum of 2 days. This is a normal side effect profile for a vaccine. We didn't observe so far serious cases, which and therefore we didn't need to pause the clinical trial. So the safety profile appears to be fine, but of course we are continuing to collect safety data up to 2 years from our study, which will provide a huge safety database supporting the tolerability of the vaccine. The second important aspect of this study is efficacy. And here the question is if the vaccine is able to prevent infection in vaccinated people. And we publish on Monday our first data, and this is the worldwide first data for any vaccine for efficacy. Our data showed that the vaccine is able to prevent infections with more than 90% of probability. That means we had in total 94 cases of infection in the total group of placebo plus vaccine, but more than 90% of the infections were in the placebo group, indicating that the vaccine has a high efficacy. This is interim data, and we will generate additional data in the coming weeks. And so this will be data in the coming weeks. We are awaiting data for 164 infections, and we will also report whether the vaccine, how good the vaccine works in elderly and younger people.
Doctor, how should the vaccine be administered? Is it in two shots? And for how long is the person immune after taking the second shot?
So our vaccine is indeed with two doses. So we have two intramuscular injections into the arm on day one and on day 22. And the vaccine after the second dose induces a strong immune response, which starts to prevent the people after 28 days. We have no long-term data at the moment for prevention and protection. We are collecting this data. So far, the investigations show that with our 3 months immunogenicity data, we have still a strong immune response after 3 months. We are collecting more information, and in the coming months, we will be able to tell whether the vaccine has still a good immune response after 6 months, 1 year. So the data will be collected. We need to be patient and wait for the data.
Doctor, you had mentioned in one of the interviews that you still need a few extra weeks of trials to be able to answer specific questions about the vaccine, such as its efficacy in children versus the elderly. What type of information will you be able to give us, and when?
So in, in about 3 weeks from now, we can answer the questions how the vaccine protects elderly and younger people. Yeah, and we will provide more data, including more safety data. How long the vaccine is going to protect, so whether the vaccine is going to protect 1 year or 2 years, we can't answer that because we don't have data for 1 year. So we started our clinical trial in July, and therefore we can only say in July 2021 if the vaccine is protecting for 1 year. But I personally expect seeing the immune response that the vaccine will have a strong immune response also after 1 year. So it could be that after 1 year, vaccinated people need an additional vaccination that would not be harmful. But if the immune response is even after 1 year very strong, we can wait longer. But we need to be patient because this long-term data require time.
Doctor, have you tested the vaccine on children, and how safe is it for children?
So we started vaccinating children. The first group of children which have been vaccinated is from 12 to 16 years old. We are now also in discussion with the regulatory authorities in Europe and in the United States to identify the time for starting vaccination children of younger age of 5 to 12 and from 3 to 5 years of age, and the details of these plans are not yet available. We expect that we can announce that also in the coming weeks.
There has been doubts about the politicizing of the vaccine approval process. In the US, you are seeking an accelerated approval process, which US law permits. But in the EU, it seems that the process needs to take its time. Which approval will you wait for before rolling out your product?
So it is important that we serve for science and medicine and not for politics. It is important that we follow the rules of drug development, and this rules tells us that we can make the vaccine only available if we get an authorization or an approval of the vaccine. We have submitted already our approval initiation process to the European regulatory authorities and to the Canadian authorities. So they are already evaluating, reviewing our data. We are in close contact with the FDA, the American Health Organization. We are talking to the Chinese Health Organization and to the United Kingdom Health Organization. And this takes time. I expect that we will not get an approval to supply vaccines before mid of December. Yeah? And if we get approval from the first European or US authorities, we will also, of course, continue to apply also in other regions of the world to ensure that we can supply the vaccine wherever it is needed.
So, doctor, let me understand that properly. So basically, you need the approval in the United States. Once you get that, you can sell only in the United States. Is that right?
That is correct. Yes, this is not in our decision. It is a decision of the health organizations. Yeah, and in Europe, it's the European Medicinal Agency.
So when do you expect to get EU approval?
So we are, as I said, we are already talking to the authorities in Europe, and this is a very close collaboration. But you have to consider these are 10,000 pages of documentation, and it takes time to review that. The authorities come up with questions. We have to answer this question. It takes some time. So everyone is working very hard to accomplish an approval as soon as possible. But quality requires time.
How much is your production capacity once you get the approval? Let's say you get the approval today. Will the product be ready tomorrow, and in what quantities?
So we are producing vaccine doses at the moment. Our goal is to make up to 50 million vaccine doses available this year, and up to 1.3 billion doses available together with our partner Pfizer in the next year. And we have also a collaboration with Fosun, and with this collaboration, we intend also to independently supply hundreds of million doses, additional vaccine doses to the China region.
When do you expect the vaccine to be rolled out on a wide scale across the world, and at what price will it be sold?
It is important at the global scale. We can produce large doses, but the amount that we can produce is not sufficient to serve the whole planet. Therefore, it is important, and that this requires many pharmaceutical companies to work together to ensure a global supply. We are collaborating at the moment with the European Union, with the COVAX initiative, and with other initiatives to also enable supply of the vaccine to the economically weaker countries at a lower price. And I am confident that together with other companies like AstraZeneca, like Janssen, we will be able in 2021 to serve several billions of vaccines worldwide, to make it happen that we can stop the pandemic, not only in the rich countries, but also in the poor countries.
So, doctor, the countries have to actually place early orders in order to make sure that they get the quantities needed. So have you received any orders or pre-orders from the Arab world?
So we have announced a number of pre-orders, including the pre-orders from the European Union. We are currently in discussion with more than 30 governments. And once we have new alignments, we will publish that. So there are ongoing discussions with a number of governments. Pre-orders are important because we have to work also on the logistical chain for transportation and distribution. This is not an easy task because this must be coordinated. And we are, for example, with the German government, We are in close collaboration to ensure if the vaccine is approved in Europe, that we can ensure also a supply, for example, by delivering the vaccine to university sites and thereby enabling that from the university sites the vaccine can be supplied to and administered to the people.
Transportation and the logistics of distributing the vaccine are delicate, as per our understanding. What are the requirements for the safe transportation of the vaccine? And will you keep manufacturing centralized, or will you manufacture in different parts of the world? And are there any limitations on the storage?
So this is indeed important. The transportation of the vaccine has to be done at minus 70 degrees. This is organized and coordinated by our partner Pfizer, who has an excellent worldwide network and complete logistical chain to ensure that the vaccines can be transported to any place on the planet. After transportation at minus 70, the vaccine is usually stored in special freezers, which are available in most hospitals, yeah? and if the vaccine needs to be applied, then a box with, for example, 25 or 100 vaccines are taken out from the freezers and can be put into a normal freezer at 2 to 8 degrees. So this is just the normal freezer, and in this freezer, this box can be stored for up to 5 days. So that means at the sites of administration, people have 5 days to administer the vaccine. And if the box is empty, then a new box from the minus 80 freezer can be taken out and put again into the to the normal freezer.
Doctor, the CEO of Pfizer, Albert Bourla, sold 62% of his holdings in Pfizer shares the day that the efficacy data was announced. What does this mean for the safety of the product?
This is something which is completely normal. We discussed the safety profile. So the safety profile has been evaluated by an independent data monitoring board, and they evaluated the safety profile as absolutely benign and well-tolerated vaccine. And Albert Bourla, is, as any other shareholder, can decide when and why to sell his shares. And I think we should respect that.